In this screencast, I will show you how to create a word cloud using the web-based tool Wordle. Word clouds are great ways to summarize a bunch of text and to see what are some themes that come out of some text or a web page, because the most frequently appearing words will show up in your Wordle as larger and more prominent. Wordle is one of many web-based tools that you can use to create word clouds, and it is quite easy to use, and you don't even need to create an account on Wordle. First, go to Wordle, Wordle.net, and click on the link that says Create Your Own. Then click in the text box and paste in a bunch of text from a piece of writing, perhaps a discussion posting, or some other kind of assignment that you have completed, or you could put a URL of any kind of web page that has text on it. So for this example, I'm going to paste in an overview of one of the classes that I teach. And then you can click the Go button. Wordle is Java-based, so it will ask you if you want to run the application, and I'm going to go ahead and click Run. And I have updated my Java, so if yours is out of date, it might ask you to update your Java, and you can go through the steps that it takes to do that. So just by doing those few things, I have created my word cloud. And I can just take this word cloud and save it. It provides a link at the lower right. If I scroll down a little bit, you can see save as PNG. And I can save that file and put it in my teaching materials or post it in social media, do whatever I want to with it. Or I can further edit my word cloud by changing the font face, the color scheme, the kinds of words that appear. So let me show you a few of those editing features. First of all, you can click a randomize button at the lower left, and I'll show you what happens there. And that basically changes the color scheme and the font face and the orientation of the words in a random way. So it'll just choose a different font face and color scheme and orientation at random. If you go up to the upper left, you can see that there is a way to undo what you just did. So I could undo randomize and go back to the previous way that it looked, and then undo it again and go back. I can choose to make all of the words either lowercase or uppercase, which could be helpful if I wanted to not have two of the same word, one of them being capitalized and one not. For instance, if I had technology at the beginning of a sentence and it would be capitalized, and also technology in the middle of the sentence uncapitalized, then it would appear twice in my Wordle, once as capitalized and once as not. So if I made all of my words lowercase, then they would all just appear one time and not be duplicated, and they would not be distinguished between a word that appears at the beginning of a sentence. You can also remove common words in a variety of languages, and we're of course looking at English right now. And another feature within the language menu is to show the word counts. So a word cloud shows you in a graphical way how frequently a word appears in a bunch of text, and the frequency table will show you in a numerical way how often the words appear. So looking at this table, some of the common words that don't appear in the word cloud, like "and," have been omitted. "To" has been omitted, but here we can see technology has a count of 3. and it does appear quite large in our word cloud. So looking at the font menu, you can choose a variety of different font faces. For instance, steelfish looks like this. Grilled cheese is more whimsical. Kenyan coffee. So you can choose a font face that suits you. In the layout menu, you can choose a maximum number of words to appear in your word cloud. So if it's a large body of text, even with omitting common words, you might want to further reduce the number of words in your word cloud to make it clear the more popular words. And right now we're looking at a maximum word of 150, but I could change that in that option. You can change the way that they appear as having more of a rounded edge or straighter edges. So this looks more rectangular-ish in my word cloud, and a rounder edge would look more of an oval shape. The orientation is horizontal right now, but you could do it mostly horizontal and then some of the words would appear vertically. That is the layout that I tend to use since I read left to right in English, but you can fit in more words by having a few of them vertically. But it's up to you and your preference. You could do half and half. You could do any layout that you think makes sense to you. And then the color scheme. They provide a number of palettes, such as Shooting Star and Organic Carrot. And then you can further customize it by having a little variation, some variation, lots of variation, or a wild variation. So we're currently looking at Organic Carrot with a little variation. Let me show you what it would look like with lots of variation. So you can see that there are more extremes to the shades of colors that are used, and it gets even more extreme with the wild variation. So for this example, I'm going to choose milk paints with lots of variation. And if there was a particular word that I wanted to delete, for instance, using, I could right-click or command-click and click the Remove Using option. Let me show you that again. How about the word rather? And I remove it and it reorients the word cloud. So you can print the word cloud or you can save it when it is in a satisfactory format and color scheme. Save it to your computer, give it a name, and click Save, and it will be a PNG file. And that is how you use the web-based tool Wordle to create a word cloud from a bunch of text.